All right, 3-point perspective boxes. And before I begin, I want to let you guys know I'm treating you today. Let's see if I can get this in the shot. So this pen looks like a normal pen. And, you know, for the most part it is. But for any of you supply nerds out there, and that's not a, I'm definitely not, that's not a mean thing to say, but some people do get really into art supplies. This is actually, I don't know if you can see it on the label, a Waterman pen. So, you know, these retail for, you know, between $80 and $100. I don't remember exactly what I paid for it, but it is like a legit fountain pen. It's, I mean, you can even see like the ink reservoir in here. If I wanted to, this is a disposable reservoir. They actually, this is how good this bad boy is. They actually make refillable reservoirs if you wanted to get super fancy. So I bought this maybe 4 or 5 years ago, and it's kind of like, I don't know, Inktober rolls around, and I start with the best intention of having a full Inktober, but then it's like I don't do a drawing every day, and I've just decided this year that I'm not going to feel bad. Like, it's, you know, I'm not, you know, the strongest ink artist, so this will be good for me. But what I'm going to do with this Waterman is I am going to draw, and this is what I want you guys to do. We're gonna draw 10 3-point perspective boxes. All right, so we're doing two pieces of paper today, or one large sheet like mine, but I am going to draw 10 3-point perspective boxes. I'm not going to talk too much because, you know, we already covered a lot of this in the demo. So this is more for your observation, but I am drawing 10 3-point perspective boxes in ink. And you'll notice, like, even on this first line, it's like I set my start point, set my end point, and draw. And I might even, with a pen like this, you got a lot of range with your line. So I might even, you know, put these lines in very lightly in the beginning, like almost like, but then the thing is, when I go to darken the line, I'm going to make sure that I don't want to get into a position where I'm like doing this to make my lines. You can do a light line and then you can hammer it in, but none of these tarantula lines, you know, the hairy lines, unless that's what we're trying to do.